Where we'll start is really why do we have this program, why is it important to us? So initially, I think all of you, I know you're all well aware, very difficult to find middle skill team members or maintenance team members. So this program is kind of a build your own program to help with that problem. So we do find those folks that have a 2-year technical degree or 3 years of maintenance experience, so they are middle skilled, but then still fall through the process somewhere in our testing. So they are middle skilled, but the skill level just isn't quite high enough. This program should ensure that these students, that doesn't happen with these students. And I'll get into a little bit more on the lines of that. So, it doesn't, this program also works on other gaps, so not just the technical side. And I know from some of the workforce development meetings that I've sat through, a lot of you, I talk about the same thing. So some of the professional behaviors, some of those gaps that in some of our hires, not just maintenance, but also production. And then manufacturing core for Toyota, and a lot of you as well have listed some of your core that you teach within your company. We're encompassing all of that into this program. So our professional behaviors that we spend the most time focusing on in this program is attendance, diligence, initiative, teamwork, communication. So these interpersonal skills, these things we really teach through our, mostly through our manufacturing core exercises. So these are taught through both at BU and Toyota. So really while they're working at Toyota and while they're in class at BU. Our manufacturing core exercises that we focus on, safety culture, 5S, lean manufacturing, problem solving, and then machine reliability. Again, we use these not only to teach those subjects, but then also the professional behaviors. So we line them up with the semesters that they have at school. They start with a curriculum, so some of the classes are taught by Chris. Some of the other maintenance group leaders or leaders teach some of these courses, so we kick it off with a 1 or 2 day curriculum. Then they have assignments associated with that. So some of them are team assignments. Some of them are individual assignments or problem-solving activities. There are written essays associated with some of these. And, you know, the students learn a lot from that, you know. So they build their own schedule. So they'll have a target date to have completed with these assignments. But they're responsible to get the work done and on their own time. So they build their own schedules. They, again, work together to problem solve. They, so, you know, all of these kind of work with the teamwork and the diligence and the initiative. And then they communicate at the end, communication at each end of each one of these. They report out, and a lot of times it's to the top level of leadership. So their communication skills are being worked on all the time, and that's a really good way for them to get out and have to do report out on their activities, have things organized in a manner that people can understand. These folks go through a multi-skilled curriculum, so electrical, fluid, power, mechanical, and then fabrication. And you'll hear me mention this a couple of times, but they have to be college ready, so they have to be college algebra, English Comp 1 ready to be able to begin in the program. There's no time for remediation. However, we do have some students who aren't quite there yet, and you know, Chris works up with a lot of these students to educate them on, you know, maybe you start the first year and you do your general education classes. We get some of those out of the way, and then the next year they join the AMT. And we do see a lot of them do that. So it doesn't mean that they can't participate, but it just means that they have a little bit more to do prior to coming into the program. At the end of the program, you know, what you'll see is you'll see a faster technical learner, a strong problem solver, effective verbal and written communication skills, effective interpersonal skills, natural team worker, because they're kind of forced into it with this, you know, some other manufacturing core and their curriculum, and qualified for the next level. So I think there's a slide in here where we talk about numbers, but a lot of our students are already promoted to team leader. We expect to see future group leaders, assistant managers, and even team managers out of this program. This slide, the purpose behind this slide is, you can see the red dots. These are FANG, or Federation of Advanced Manufacturing Education. FANG is basically AMT groups with additional companies involved in it, so it's the collaboration. And the red ones show where there's a Toyota factory involved, and the black ones show where these are collaborations or FANG groups without a Toyota factory. So the purpose behind this is you don't need a Toyota group involved to start your own AMT program or FANG program. And we'll go into how to get started. Now there is training associated with coming into this that Toyota does lead, but anyone can start their own program. And this slide sort of sums up what I spoke about in one of the previous ones. So you've got your technical core curriculum, so the degree that they're working on. Within that degree, so at school and both at work, we're working on the six professional behaviors. We're also working on manufacturing core exercises. So in the end, you know, when these students graduate, you've got a well-rounded team member coming into your facility. This is a better image of how it's all laid out. So semester by semester, and at the top corner, you'll see kind of the work and school. So they go to school 3 days a week or to the university 3 days a week, and then they're at the plant 2 days a week, learning hands-on. The top is the general education and how it's laid out by semester. And then the next goes into the technical core curriculum. So early on, we get into electricity and fluid power. On the manufacturing floor experience, you'll notice that in the first semester, they're in production. And there's two reasons for that. One of them being that we want the students to experience the production, what the production team member does, appreciate what they do, but also understand that the production team member is the expert when it comes to the equipment. When they say that there's an issue with the equipment, they really do know what they're talking about. They may not be able to explain to you the technical reasons behind it or exactly what's going on, but they do know when the equipment is acting up. The other reason is a lot of these students, so it's a training program, a lot of these students don't come in with a technical background at all. Some of them have been Project Lead the Way students. Some of them have not. So we have some that we have to teach what different tools are. It's that level of experience. So we have them in production, one, to understand that part of the business and appreciate the student, the team members, the work that they do and their knowledge, but also to ensure the safety of the student as well. They don't have the background to really learn, even be an observer of maintenance at that time. The following semesters, then they begin their training. The manufacturing core exercises, as I spoke to earlier, they are lined up with each semester. And again, we try to use these both to teach them, you know, those manufacturing core, the curriculum and the purpose behind it, but then also we teach professional behaviors. attendance I didn't speak about, but it's one of the ones that we really, it's outside of the manufacturing core exercises. So early on, we set the, so really an orientation, we set the attendance policy, explain that to them. But their attendance is required both at school and at work. So for us, I can only speak to Toyota, but they are allowed 4 occurrences within a 6-month period. And again, that's both at school and at work. So they, professors at the school, they take attendance every morning. And if a student is 1 minute late, they're late, and that's one of their occurrences. And these are really for the emergency situation. So therefore, I'm sick, or I did have a flat tire on my way to work, or I need to get to the doctor or the dentist or something like that. When they're using frivolously, those students don't seem to make it through. So we don't have that happen very often, but we have that. But this is an example. This is not Indiana's. There's a picture of it a little bit later, but this is a Advanced Manufacturing Center. This is actually TMMK's college, if you will. So they do everything out of this center. So they teach their curriculum. There's some of their both lab and curriculum is done out of the center. They've got, can't see it very well on here, but they do have a section where they can sit down and they can go through their PowerPoint or whatever the instructor might be doing, and then the most of it is hands. So how do you start? Employers really get together and form a board, so they need a president, vice president, secretary, treasurer, and decide on what is that curriculum that we need for these certain companies. When we started, it was just Toyota, and then quickly we had a few other companies join. But if you're starting out the collaborative, then what is, you know, what do we need for the collaborative? And then choose your college partner. They may have to add faculty. Vincent University is our college partner, and they did have to add faculty initially when we started. We actually do have 2 cohorts with them right now, so there's, you know, that's 48 students with the collaborative that we partner with them for. And they added 1 instructor immediately, and then a couple of years later added a second. Not with that second group, we kind of tried it and then decided that they needed that additional amount. So really depending on the college, but you do want them to be focusing on, again, those manufacturing core exercises, the professional behaviors, all of that is in these courses. So the technical courses, they're also teaching these things as well. They have activities associated with. Employers and college faculty go to the AMT Academy to learn how to implement. So that's, you know, I was speaking to earlier, anyone can start their own program, but there is training to you know, be a part of the family, training that you need to go to. That's July, every year in July. It's a 2-week curriculum, and it's taught by Toyota North America Production Support Center. Dennis Parker leads that. In August, really, each FAME employer should be going to the colleges, to the high schools, and starting recruiting. So we typically, again, we have Chris Mullen, who is dedicated to this program, and he really spends the majority of his time from August through October visiting schools, talking to students. And he doesn't just talk to the, you know, technical students. He tries to get them all. And that's one thing that we've seen from this program is we've seen diversity really improves for maintenance with this program. So I want to say our diversity for the plant in maintenance was about 3% prior to this program. In this program, we are pulling in about 25% diverse students in the program. So it has helped us a lot there as well. Interviews on offers done no later than February. So that is kind of the drop dead. Really, as you're going to the schools and as people are applying, you want to be looking for those that meet your qualifications, and you really want to be interviewing as you're doing this. So as much as you can, you know, kind of be simultaneously. A lot of these students are very capable students. We have several that are valedictorians. So, you know, they could go into engineering. There's other things they could do. They like this program because of the hands-on aspect of it. They like working with their hands. So my point being, you don't want to let them sit out there too long where they will get accepted to another university or apply to another university and kind of go on a different path. So we try to, as much as we can, get as much of it wrapped up as we can by December. We have had some stragglers out there where we're going in a little bit later, but the sooner the better we'll get back, because they are going to do something. You know, if this is what they want to do, they want to kind of have that finalized and know what they're doing. So our students start in June, mid-June for the first semester. That's really worked. They start, again, like I said, their first semester is in production, so they come in June, they do the orientation with all of the other AMT students from other companies, and then we begin them training on the processes in production. The reason we bring them in early to do that is when they start school and they're only working 2 days a week, then it's not enough time for them to pick up their production processes and get that full experience. The formal AMT orientation should be with all students. So all of your partners, if you have partners, should be included in the AMT orientation. It really should be one. And you may need to go and do a different orientation at your company that's associated with your company. That's totally fine, but the core of the AMT orientation should be together and everyone's hearing the same message. And we do ours at Vincent University now. We used to do it at the Plant and Business Center, but more of a central location. These are our partners, so Thyssen Krupp Presta, they joined us the first year. So we kind of had the plans in place, and they contacted us and immediately joined us. Metal Technologies, Barbest Food, Berry, again, Vincent's University is our university partner, Toyota Boshoku America, Hershey, and then Flair. Program selection, again, they must be college algebra ready and English Comp 1 ready. We wait our interviews, basically, you know, they have to have that, and then we do an interview. It's about a 30-minute interview. And the interview is not, we're not looking for that highly technical skilled person. We're looking for more of the professional behaviors. So, you know, the person that really wants to be here, that we feel like has the initiative to work hard through the program, because it is a very stringent program to go through. And then project lead the way. Students are preferred. However, we have many who have, again, no experience. This is the Indiana Advanced Manufacturing Center, and about 70% of our curriculum or classroom is held in this room. And again, you know, the purpose behind this is it's a lot of hands-on versus the normal your presentation stuff. This is a good layout of the entire program. So again, they start in mid-June for us and begin their training, orientation and training in production to learn the processes. So all of that is full-time at that point. And they earn a lot of money that they can use during that first semester in college. The next two semesters at school, the first one there in production, and then they move to maintenance in that second semester. Thus, see the blue spot there that's work only. That first summer between their freshman and their sophomore year, we added in an entire work summer so they don't go to school. It used to be that was a school semester. We've added in this work summer because it, one of the things that we noticed with the program is, again, them only being able to work 2 days a week in maintenance really wasn't enough time for them to gain the skill level they needed with just being there 2 days a week. So we added in this school work summer, and it really, really did in and they learned a whole lot over the summer and ahead of some of the other students. Then as they're there just 2 days a week through their final year, they're able to do more because they have that full-time summer. And then they do have an additional summer that they have to tap on at the end of that year. So, you know, they graduate in August versus most of the students graduate. So here are some of our results. So 85% completion rate from all the companies. 100% job placement, even if not with sponsoring companies. So we have had, and I know some of our partners I'm sure have as well, had students who got to the end of this, they got their degree, and then they chose to go somewhere else. I know for Toyota, a lot of those students have come back, and now they do work for us. But there is no guarantee that at the end of that they'll stay with your company. And it also, it's no guarantee that a student that will hire them, so the company will hire them. So you're not held to anything on this. We need every one of ours, but if we have some that still maybe they made it through the program, but they're going to that third attendance every time, we're only 6 months and then they're getting another one. We kind of look for those things and we look for the ones who show the most initiative. So we have, I spoke to a little bit earlier about promotion. So six of our AMT students right now have already been promoted to the team leaders, the ones that we hired. And we expect, more from that. We expect additional team leaders. We expect to see group leaders. We expect to see assistant managers and managers like that. Started as Toyota program, and now we have 8 additional partners. So back to the slide that showed you our partners. It's a collaborative for us. It's not just a Toyota.